Well, it is Friday, April 7th, 2023. Let's take a look at the black milks. So Atlas looks like he will shed anytime now. He is no longer cloudy. Just make sure I haven't missed anything. Yep, he's out of his humid hide. Georgia, who is deep in shed. And she's also very thick right now, and I'm hoping that's because she is full of follicles. So as soon as she sheds, I'll put them together and hope for lots of babies. I had 12 good eggs from her last year. So 12 again would be fantastic. Heck, I'd be happy with 8. So whatever you want to give me, big girl, I would appreciate it. And then Venus, her baby girl from last year, she is coming out of shed as well. She was a problem eater for me for a while, but she's doing great now. In fact, she may be out right now. I'm about to give her nose a scratch and start that shedding process. So these black milks have always been really close to my heart. Yeah, I've said it in the past that the northern pines are my favorite. And that waxes and wanes. I mean, there's something special about these black milks. And I'm hopefully getting a pair of corn snakes soon, because I also love the corns. But that's the beauty of this hobby. There's such a variety out there. But back to the black milks, Venus will hopefully be breeding with Atlas in another 2 or 3 years, because he is not her father. She has a different dad than Atlas. All right, baby girl, you shed. I'll see you soon, pumpkin. Guys, thank you for tuning in to this black milk update. Wasn't much on the snakes. But that's where I am. So hopefully we'll be putting Atlas and Georgia together in about a week. If you want a corn snake tame, Lampropeltis, the black milk is what you want. So thanks as always for watching. You don't know how much I appreciate the comments and the kind words. And I just love sharing this little part of my world with you. Happy Easter this weekend. We'll see you next time.